Hi everyone, Thao here. This is the Galaxy Watch 3. I've actually been really excited to get my hands on this ever since I heard Samsung was coming out with it. I'm a big fan of the Galaxy Watch line, mainly because they actually look like a watch I can rock on any occasion. So this is the 41mm Bluetooth version in the color Mystic Bronze. Samsung can call it whatever they want, but this is as rose gold as it gets for me. When I saw pictures of the color, I thought I was gonna hate it, but seeing it in person, I actually love it. Putting them side by side, it does make my original Galaxy Watch look a little dated in terms of styling. The new watch is definitely stunning. The watch comes paired with a 20mm leather strap with a color matching metal buckle. I'll likely pick up a sports band just for working out, but I do like the contrast stitching and overall look of this leather one. Okay, hold up. Let me put this on real quick. Here's what it looks like on my wrist. What do you guys think? And before you guys ask, I did measure my wrist, and the circumference of my wrist measures exactly 5.4 inches. So if you have a wrist size similar to mine, here you go. Physically, it just has a leaner, sleeker design. The buttons are now circular with the word Galaxy Watch etched in on the top one. I like that attention to detail. The casing on all models are stainless steel, but a titanium version will be coming out later. There's also no more plastic on the backing, which was a common complaint. In terms of specs, we've got some solid upgrades over the original, including double the storage, a small bump in RAM, and Bluetooth 5.0 instead of 4.2. They did shrink the battery size, which is interesting. So I'll have to do some testing to see what the battery life is like. The whole pairing process took about 5 minutes or so, and you need the Galaxy Wearable app too. First impressions. From the design upgrades to the fact that they give you a leather strap, this definitely leans towards a fashion piece. While I wouldn't wear something like the Apple Watch or Active 2 for a night out, I can totally see myself rocking this. It just blends in so much better with a nice outfit. So Samsung states that the watch is 8% smaller, 14% thinner, and 15% lighter than the original, but to me, the difference isn't that noticeable. If you felt the original Galaxy Watch was too bulky or too thick, this isn't going to change your mind, because on the wrist, they feel very similar. But like I said, this does look more sleek visually. Something I noticed immediately is that the screen is brighter. So this is great if you use your watch a lot outdoors. Another big reason why you'd opt for something like this over the Active line is the physical rotating bezel. I did notice that the Watch 3 has a slightly different sound. It's hands down the best way to navigate a smartwatch in my opinion, and it protects the screen when you accidentally whack it against a doorframe, which from experience, I'm telling you, will happen. It also opens customization options with third-party bezel covers like this Rinke one I have on my original. On the fitness side of things, the watch is capable of blood oxygen, blood pressure, and EKG monitoring. Unfortunately, blood pressure and EKG aren't active at the moment here in Canada. I know those of you who bought the Active 2 are still waiting for EKG support too. So hopefully Samsung gets these features approved and out as soon as possible. If these features are important to you, I would highly recommend you wait for them to be officially supported before picking one up. Besides the typical heart rate, steps, and floor tracking, Samsung added some additional fitness and health features, including an advanced running coach, VO2 max estimate, and sleep score, which breaks down your sleep patterns. They've also included a trip and fall detection feature that will notify a contact when it detects that you've taken a fall, similar to what you see on the Apple Watches. There's some cool stuff here, and I'm looking forward to seeing how well it does for general fitness. When it comes to software, just from the small amount of time I've spent with it, the experience is very similar. If you're coming from any Galaxy Watch, there doesn't appear to be many big changes. A couple notable additions can be found in the Labs menu. The first one lets you answer a call by opening and closing your hand. I was skeptical about it at first, but you know what? It actually works pretty good. Pretty cool, especially if your other hand is preoccupied with groceries or something. The second one lets you mute or silence incoming calls by rotating your wrist. Not quite as helpful, but hey, it's there if you want it. You've got a few new watch faces. I'm loving this animated weather one. Definitely a highlight for me. If you like a little bit of randomness in your life, there's also the shuffle watch face that cycles between your favorite or all watch faces based on a schedule that you can set. Here's a quick rundown of all the watch faces that come preloaded on the watch. Of course, there are plenty more on the Galaxy App Store if you're not feeling any of these. All your typical smartwatch functions like taking calls, checking notifications, and Samsung Pay are all still here as you would expect. I've taken calls on the watch and it sounded good, but I did notice that the vibration motor isn't quite as strong. Overall, with the Galaxy Watch 3, the biggest change is definitely the physical design. It's been updated with a more sleek, modern, fashion-forward aesthetic, which I'm a fan of. Coming from the original Galaxy Watch, the upgraded sensors on the back are also definitely much needed. I'm gonna have to spend more time with it before I share my full thoughts, but if there's anything specific that you want me to cover in my full review, definitely leave it in the comment section below. As usual, thank you all so much for watching. Until the next one, I'm out of here.